And first of all, 1.1 reception of guests. Welcome, welcome. A lot of people here tonight.
Guests.
Thank you for coming. We have on under 1.2 agenda review and revisions. Are there any revisions?
So your negotiation rep is tonight.
Okay.
The reason I'm here is if you'd like to go into executive session, what wasn't said at the Washington Center will give you more details. The other two are doing that.
Okay.
I need to do the two boards, so if you're one of them, too.
Okay. Would you like to do that first?
I would if I take 5 minutes. I advise you, it's your decision, that you should go into executive sessions since you're in contract negotiations.
Sure. Okay. How about we put that on as a discussion item, Bill, as the first item for discussion. We'll keep that as 3.1 and bump the rest of them down. Before we do that, any public comments or correspondence anyone wants to bring up at the start of the meeting?
I was just wondering, unfortunately, I came late to the meeting prior to this. I was wondering if you could recap if there's anything that would be of interest in particular Act 46 that might not get brought up again.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything that we won't cover again under the Act 46 update here. Bill did walk through the different things to be voted on Tuesday the 19th. And there's a handout for that if you didn't get it. So we can get you a copy of that handout.
It must be on U32's website or somewhere.
It's on the Washington.
Yep.
Underneath.
And, you know, I'll discuss this again, but just very generally, the lawsuit is up in the air, the legislature is up in the air, we don't know what might happen. So, but we are going to have our organizational meeting on the 19th. There is a court date on Friday. There's something could possibly happen on Friday. Yep. All right. Any other public comments or correspondence? Future meetings. Like I said, we have the organizational meeting on the 19th. This is at the U32 auditorium. Bill, and just remind me, I think I have on my calendar, not everyone is on these committees, but a transition board meeting on the 20th and an articles meeting on the 21st.
That's correct. A transition board immediately after the organizational
meeting. Immediately after the organizational meeting as well. Okay. Great. All right. Down below under 3.3 calendar planning, I think we'll also want to talk about town meeting day, pre-town meeting, and any budget informational meetings, if any, that we want to try to put together. All right, consent agenda, approve the minutes. We have three sets of minutes to approve, January 7th, January 28th, and January 29th, in all of our special meetings, scrambling to put together a local Berlin budget. I'm assuming everyone's had a chance to take a look at those. If not, we can take a few more minutes. And then I would entertain a motion to approve those as a group, or if you have individual corrections you'd like to make, you can pull out any one of them.
I'm happy with them. I would move to approve all three.
Okay, is there a second?
A second.
Any discussion? Those in favor of approving the three sets of minutes signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. And those opposed, no. The ayes have it, the motion carries, and those three sets of minutes are approved. Now we'll go into the discussion agenda. Bill has asked that we talk about contract negotiations. It's still in process. It's not officially ratified yet. So we'd like to have a motion to go into executive session to briefly talk about the status of contract negotiations. Their motion.
I would make that motion. That we go into executive session to discuss contract negotiations.
Okay. Is there a second?
A second.
Right. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And we'll ask members of the public to step outside. We'll make this as quick as possible.
Could you guys just kind of opening the door from the back?
Sure thing.
Hey, we heard Chuck.
Heard the word chocolate and
said,
open the door. All right.
As you know, Chris, and Bill, before I rotate on these meetings, so if there's anything else that's on your agenda you'd like me to speak to, more than welcome to, and you're a great hands
Yes, please. Can you talk to us about the town sewer easement, which is item 3.2?
Yeah. So it was agreed to, we use the same council as the town of Berlin, which is Cameron, Sigler, and Tom Downer, and we agreed.
Still land back?
Both the town and the school district agreed that they could represent both of us, different partners within the organization, within their firm, that they could represent us. They sent me a copy of the sewer easement today, which received it, pretty good to me. I asked back to the paralegal for all the blanks that needed to be filled in, what was the date when this board would adopt it, or authorize me to sign it. But there, I think it should be filled in, this was there. I think it was pretty self-explanatory, like, pretty standard.
Karen, any concerns, either of you, I mean, any concerns about when construction might take place, or where it is on the school property, or anything like that we need to be thinking about?
I mean, I think I said last time, it's, anything that is disruptive to when the kids are there. Going out back to recess, it looks like part of it might go through the garden, which looks like it might be very, not a lot of impact. So like anything, we always look at, when kids aren't in session, or do any sort of outdoor or indoor project, so definitely not only that it's an advocate for.
Any questions?
I guess my concern, my concern is the where and when as well, if it was going through one of the athletic fields, the baseball field, or the soccer field, or the baseball season, or soccer season, so.
Sounds like it's fairly close to the back of the school and then through the, near the garden.
Picture that was, I remember that.
Yeah.
I think we made it fairly clear last time that we would prefer it be done, the work be done out of school days.
Yeah.
I think it'd be a good idea to have whoever their representative, when all is signed and sealed, have them come over and lay it out and say, here's where we have to interrupt and see how much disruption there might be and what you can live with. And I think, you know, I think you should make that decision based on school use.
I mean, it's outside, so that's a good start.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, and it's good digging, it won't take them too long.
Yeah. All safety.
You've been digging out there recently?
Not recently, but.
You know, all safety precautions will be in place, so if there's bigger equipment and we don't have a choice, we'll just, we'll play around it.
Right.
And I don't know if this is part of the contractors, or if this is something we look for as negotiating, but the landscape repair as well.
It's in the community agreement that everything we return to is consistent.
And we've had an attorney review it, and there didn't seem to be anything to be worried about.
This is pretty standard easement, which is not a big deal. I think it's more of what he was bringing up. It seemed to be very.
Tom Badowski.
Tom was very new to the
community. Yeah.
Okay. Is there any concern about the sign-off by this board, the timing of the sign-off so that it's done before another board?
I haven't thought about it. I should probably call Tom and say, you know, what your timetable is. I had it today and sent it back and said, just tell me who does the research to build these plans. That was my general question.
When it's complete, I forgot the access. How often will they access the easement?
They probably won't access it unless they also break the pipe.
Okay.
But it tells us we can't build anything.
Right.
And it'll mean less interruption than we have currently had or historically had with the pump station, because it eliminates the pump station. And that's been a maintenance issue for them.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Thank you. One other thing, Bill, I guess in town meeting preparation, if we can move to that. Will either you or Lori be available for pre-town meeting or town meeting, since we have a budget presentation that we need to make?
I can be available. I can be there.
Okay.
And, you know, I've been in pre-town meetings, I think last year as well.
Okay.
And I just.
Thank you.
Or I'll capture the dates.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah.
Will there be a video as there has been in the past going over the budget?
Good question.
So we're, we don't have to play around with personal time to the video.
The way it was in the, has been in the past, okay.
All I did was narrate.
Yeah, they put together the PowerPoint and then the chair would narrate. So we can talk more about that, about outreach, about the budget and how we wanna do that, but I appreciate that, Bill, thank you.
Just I have to be.
Yep, understood.
Just so you know, lots of ballots to start to go out.
Okay, good to know. Does anybody else have anything for Bill before he makes his way to another meeting? Thanks, Bill.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, we've made a little bit of a mess of this agenda, but I think we've covered contract negotiation, and just for clarity in the minutes, I think we could call, say that that was 3.1A, was contract negotiation, we went into executive session, we came out, took no action. 3.1B is town meeting preparation. Anything further, for further discussion for town meeting preparation? Knowing that Bill will be there, or Lori, and knowing that we're gonna get a lot of questions, I would imagine, about Act 46, about the budget itself, and we have yet to really do a lot of outreach on the budget numbers yet. So maybe I just open it up for a discussion for everybody on how we wanna try to get information out to the voters, including our friends in attendance here today.
Go to the studio, you can do anything you want there, and I think people would appreciate it. I'm a little worried when we were talking about the meeting on the 19th, and somebody would make a motion to maybe bring somebody to stand up and like, oof. I think at this point, whoever's standing up on the 19th better be really prepared with an organized, thoughtful presentation and knowing, making sure that he or she knows exactly what they're talking about. Because I can think that could turn ugly fast. And I think the same at our meeting, because we know whatever budget we vote on, next year might be a little more.
I think the difficulty with the meeting on the 19th is its purpose is not to be informative about Act 46, which is problematic. And so Bill, as our superintendent, is only open the meeting.
Right.
As all these statutorily allowed to do.
And then we will. Somebody on this board to be able to talk about whether, I mean, you can speak the chair's name from the city, but who's the guy who's using the.
Oh, Matt.
Matt. Is he the chair?
Of the central.
They'll expect him to be able to stand up and talk, because people don't know what's going on.
Yeah, and I think there are a number of people that are capable of answering most of the questions that somehow or other could be empowered to do that at that meeting.
Yeah.
And I think
just
it's likely. And I think. Pardon?
I just hope they're prepared to stand up and say, yes, we're here to tell you.
We've been hearing a lot about it for quite some time. I think there are people in that group that you saw in the other room that are prepared to talk about it. And I think the same thing probably is true, will be true for Berlin's pre-town and town meeting, at least to give, you know, a thumbnail. With questions to follow. And it's hard to know where to start. We all know bits and pieces of it, some more than others. And I'm a new kid on the block, so I know enough more than maybe I care to. But I think we would be in a position to hit Act 46. And I think it's important, it'll be important for us, I believe, to talk about our budget in relation to Act 46, because my understanding is that we're not required to present a budget, but the Berlin Board felt it was responsible to prepare and present a Berlin budget.
Don't you have to have our approval to spend money? How would you get through the...
Well, that's a good question. It's a related question, but according to the sequence and the act and the sequence of implementation of the act, the new budget would replace Berlin's and all the other budgets, and therefore we did not have to present a budget.
So if we vote a local...
I'm sorry, I'm on record there wrong. You have to have authority to spend money.
Well, authority to spend it is one thing. Presenting a budget to ask for an amount is another.
Right.
But we have done that. We have done that. So we should be able to...
Yes, I know. I'm very proud of us.
And I think that's, I think that shows good faith on the part of the board. It doesn't mean that our budget either will be approved or that it will be meaningful in any way if a larger budget ends up running the district.
We have to explain all these things on town meeting day.
Well, I mean, I got involved, and I apologize for getting involved so late, but there was a couple of things that tweaked my blood pressure. And I can certainly list them for you, but I'm going to wait till the David Kelly to see what's in his lawsuit, because I don't want to raise a focus. If he's covered it in his lawsuit, if they're going to say go away. The one thing that's bothering me the most is the $2 transfer of our school and land to the supervisory union of the our money, our land. And I know Calis is looking for a right of first refusal. They've got some interesting ideas of how they're, but we shouldn't be hunkering down to protect ourselves. It all should be working in our favor. So I'd like to weigh in on that at some point.
Sure. Corinne, did you have something?
Well, I was just wondering if that town meeting and pre-town meeting, if there might be, I don't even know if there's a short, concise way to say this as far as why there's not a youth emergency budget. Because I'm sure it will be the most asked question of the day. If there's anything that people could be pointed toward if they missed it, to explain it, I think that might be nice.
Ultimately, I think the answer to that is that there was a great deal of confidence among the U32 board that there would be a forced consolidated budget in July. So they basically went all in on a consolidated budget and without covering their bets like we did in case the lawsuit does lead to an injunction.
Or when the bill passes in another year.
Right. And so they will be put in a position where they will simply have to rush to get a U32 budget done and have that voted at a special meeting somewhere.
Well, if there is nothing in writing to explain that, when people are asking, who should they get pointed to? Because a lot of the people that come in to vote on town meetings do not have access to the internet. You know, so that might be a nice thing for some people if you say, oh, it's on another website, but who else should they get pointed to if they want to know more? Because I got to admit, I certainly don't want to explain it 700 times.
You can send them to me. That's, you know. I'll do my best, and what I can't answer, I'll try to send them to someone else, but they can contact me. And it's, I think, is it Calis that kind of reversed course? They were going to present an individual budget and then decided
Middlesex
just recently. So because they thought it would be more confusing to have a local budget and then have another vote if it happened. So difference of opinion in different towns. We wanted to present the local budget. We felt we had a statutory obligation to do it, despite what AOE was saying, and a responsibility to, at least an opportunity to talk to the Berlin voters and say, here's what we're planning to do. Because for the most part, it's just all the local budgets getting rolled up into one if there is a consolidation. There's no...
Because we approved the dates for the taxes, we approved the amount for the taxes, and we approved the budget. And that's the people who approved that. So if those three things don't happen, where do you get the money from then?
That's every other town believing it's going to go to a consolidated district and will have a special vote. Yep.
At least the legislature really didn't mess up. Well,
and so either way, there would end up being another vote before July 1st, either for a U32 budget if the merger weren't going forward.
That's right.
Or for a merged budget if it did.
Yep.
And and that needs to happen before July 1st either way.
That's correct.
Right.
You got it. Anything else around town meeting preparation? So I think we should, we talked a little bit at our last special meeting when we approved the budget, the local budget, about doing a very simple communication strategy of, you know, picking out three or four things to keep it simple. And I'm trying to remember what those elements were, but I think it was that we asked for a level funded budget. Our increase in expenses over last year was less than 3%. And I'm trying to remember what the other elements of that were. Because as warned, it's still, you know, it has the mandatory language that talks about spending per equalized pupil, and that it's 4.41% higher than spending for the current year per equalized pupil, which is...
And we still don't have the current equalized pupil, is that right?
True.
We will have shortly, but...
I do not know. Right. The numbers are not.
So, you know, those numbers may change. That'll be something we'll have to correct.
But any input as to how, you know, the best way to message this budget out? You know, last year we did a kind of a, I think we did a mailing, and it was a longer explanation. Of course, there's that complicated formula, the different factors that are involved in calculating budgets, none, you know, half of which we don't even control. We talked more than half, right? Three quarters. The common level of appraisal is down in the town, so that accounts for some of it. Statewide education tax rate is set by the state. There's the yield, which is not, you know, anything that we can control. And then there's the local budget. It's the only thing that we have control over. And we made sure that was at what we thought was a responsible level, given the increases in salaries, and we did not increase staff. So, comments?
How did the mailing go?
The last time around?
Mm-hmm.
Always hard to tell.
Yeah. And the budget passed.
So, you're mailing the information sheet and all of this?
Yeah. Or did we get it onto a postcard? I'm trying to remember.
I think we at least did one postcard mailing.
A postcard mailing?
Well, that'll get to the people who don't have, you know, that right. You're talking about. It'll get to either or.
Some of it's the time, though, when it's sent out because.
Yeah, and I think we will do immediate outreach, you know, online to the school website, Front Porch Forum. Your News to Know is always helpful and reaches a lot of people. There are those ways that we can start to reach out immediately.
So I think, I know getting into equalized people formula is too confusing, but just saying that Berlin enrollment is down. Because of that, Berlin equalized pupil number is down, which we can say with confidence. And so when people see the 4%, we can explain to them that is from the equalized pupil decreasing, not our budget increasing.
That's well said for that point. That's saying it without complicating.
Page trifold kind of thing went out to residents. Just there it is with all the points.
Yep.
Yeah. Simple.
You know, numbers are good. And, you know, numbers, as far as, again, I look at a vote like this, you have some people that are going to vote yes no matter what, and some that are going to vote no matter what. But I think we were very fiscally responsible with the things that we had within our control. And those numbers look good, so the maybes should vote yes if they're made aware of those numbers.
Can we make a point of that?
Okay. Do that. All right. So I can put together a communication for the mailing, taking these elements into it. Also use that for things like Front Porch Forum and other electronic ways to get the word out. Okay, good.
And so it will go home to students, so those folks will know it will go home to students before vacation, but if you're putting out a mailing to everybody, they should know that they can combine it and not the mess.
And you also post that on the website?
Oh, as soon as I have them, I'll.
Corinne, do you have a sense of, say, the proportion of residents who don't have email access?
There's a bunch of them, and that's why I do the resource line that I record every week, trying to capture some of the people that they just can't get information otherwise, like in the newspaper. And even that, a lot of people aren't getting the Times Argus because it costs money. I mean, you can't access all the articles online unless you're paying.
Right.
And so I've certainly heard people speak to that, and not everything else makes it in the world. In the world these days, if they deliver it home, you have to pick it up somewhere. You know, so it's just a lot harder for some people to be accessing.
Yeah. As far as organizing a mailing, can we get the stickers from the towns? What we've done in the past, right? The mailing list. And has it been on? Has Lori been the one who typically would do the?
Yes.
Mail?
Not me.
Not you, Lori. The other Lori.
What are the typical ways we engage residents, or what do we usually do?
I think we're talking about what we normally.
So everything you've mentioned.
Yep, the things we've mentioned.
Is there any other ways that might be
front porch
better?
Letters to the editor from the board. If you have anything on the budget, to express anything specifically.
And then online, like electronic things. Just because I don't know.
The next school newsletter would be the only one before town meeting.
Right.
Yeah. I'm not sure what the deadline for that is. It must be a little early because of vacation.
Yeah. I think it'll be that Friday before, right? So.
And we will want to, you know, make sure we mention, I think someone already mentioned this, but of note that we're not going to have the U32 budget, so it's not going to reflect your new tax rate. Although I think the U32 budget is a very, from what we've seen so far.
About a level tax impact, it included the estimate for the U32
okay.
budget that they had supported going to the new report.
Okay. And that's in the town report, right?
Yes.
So the U32 budget and the defined tax rate won't be in there, but there's an estimate.
The estimate is about a level tax impact at this time for both budgets and at this time. The legislature has
finalized. Okay, so with U32 and Berlin's budgets as proposed, about a level tax impact.
It's only the merged one where we see Berlin so up.
True.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
We're not there yet.
Right.
Okay. Very little control over that one.
Okay.
That's the good news of today. This one.
This one's good.
Looks better than the merged one.
Okay. Anything else under town meeting preparation? Moving on, at 3.2 we covered the town sewer easement. 3.3 is calendar planning. So like we said, we've got three meetings happening next week, the organizational meeting, the transition board meeting, and the articles committee meeting. I can hardly wait.
When were those again? It's
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
Organizational,
yep.
But what's the one on Wednesday?
Transition board. So that's the board chair and the board secretary, which is me and Vera. I think Bill also said there's a transition board meeting immediately after the organizational meeting. So that means the transitional board, right after that meeting, the transitional board basically comes into existence and has some responsibilities to get us through to the election of the new board.
And then is it again at 6 o'clock on Wednesday, and is it here pre-briefing again?
Let's see. I'm not positive currently. I marked it in my calendar as happening, but I'm not sure where. I'm assuming it's here. Maybe it's on
the one on Tuesday?
WCSU, the Wednesday.
Oh, I can
the Tuesday one is definitely here in the auditorium. Let me just see if I can pull up the website real quick.
Tuesday's the organization.
Tuesday organization. And you probably know better than me. Is it under the resources page? I can't remember. Meeting resources. I am.
It'd be under announcements.
Under announcements.
Just out of curiosity, and I should know this, but is this the third rescheduling? Stand up and give like a 7-hour filibuster to prevent that from happening.
Yeah, I don't see them. I don't see them on here yet. Current.
I see the Tuesday.
I just see the Tuesday.
And so then the Thursday one is what though? It's not transitional. It's
articles. So there's this articles group that's been trying to iron out some articles that we would possibly put before the voters. Definitely not putting them before the voters on town meeting day now, but maybe at some point.
Is that a vote that will count or will be overridden by the board, she says, basically? But is it a real vote?
The articles?
Yeah.
At this point, it would be a recommendation rather than an amendment to the...
So the board can override it and do what they want?
The new board.
They could.
Can. I don't think the transitional board can.
I don't think the transitional board can.
No, the Board of Ed has to.
Oh, no, the Board of Ed.
When you say it gets voted on, you mean by the town residents?
Yes. Yeah.
And so.
All the towns.
Potentially when the U32 budget would be voted on?
Maybe. Yeah. Yep. And it's really trying to send a message to the new unified board that this is what the towns want. They could still go a different way.
Essentially customizing the formula to fit our district.
And at every turn when we're talking about coming up with different articles, we're told you can't modify this one, you can't modify that one, it's in statute, state board has interpreted it this way. So we really struggled with that too.
My concern, and I have it on record here too, is that if the community does vote to adopt the non-default committee came up with, that would in effect be a community approving of merger, and we would no longer be considered forced merge. So my concern about our own specific non-default articles being voted on and approved would basically take away any standing we have as a community member and to say that we don't want this.
We also
would say,
does that implement?
That that's the case, because there's an article that says, notwithstanding all these proposed changes, article fails, the merge fails, then there's no penalty to, in this case, it's committed to the district. It's kind of a bailout article, but I don't know if a vote by, in this case, Maryland voters would constitute approval of the
there's an article in there to address exactly your concerns. And even if we vote on this, we're not saying we want to be merged.
A lot about having this comment box at town meeting.
We have a microphone that's being passed.
But for the people that don't like microphones, just a place to gather comments.
It'd have to be a big box.
Speak now or forever hold your peace. I just wanted to add that one of the other articles, as an example of what we're struggling with, one is about school closures, and the default articles say there shall be no school closures, I think, for the first 2 years. And then we're debating whether we want to modify that. After the 2 years, it can be a vote of the entire district can close it. We want to modify that in any way to make it harder to close a particular town school. And you know, Peter and I have had different opinions on this. A lot of different opinions around the table on this. Would you want to ever close a school over a town's objection? And you know, one of the comments is, you know, a town could hold you hostage where, you know, they're down to just a couple of students and they still want to keep their school open. We as a whole have to pay for that. Why shouldn't we be able to do it over their withholding that?
Dare they demand sovereignty?
I know. So it's a really tricky question for, you know, people come at it from a lot of different angles.
And in 2 years, who owns that school?
Well, you know,
where is that sitting?
I think that's a good question. And the budget items.
Nobody.
Budget items are not cannot be changed by the town, right? The dollars and cents items, which that is one of.
And do we have a right of first refusal to whatever they want to do with our land?
I think originally when Act 46 was written, the school district, if it was closed, the town would be able to purchase it back. But there have been a lot of amendments to that. So it's unclear now. Now there's amendments that it has to be used for a certain purpose. And then there's some reimbursement to the district of any improvements or capital improvements. So there's been so many amendments.
And I heard that
it's
our land was given to us by a woman who said this must always be used for education.
It came from the Pikes.
The Pike family.
So that's got something on it already.
It said to the effect that if this ends up not being used for a school, then it reverts back to the family. But it has indeed been used for a school. So I think that could be interpreted a number of ways as far as whether it's fulfilled its intent and therefore it's no longer an issue or not.
Yeah.
For the record, the Pike family also donated to the town the land for the previous school across the street. And the old fire station, which is where the credit union is now.
Oh, yeah.
So they're
the whole area.
Very, very generous. They own all that area at the time. It's Marcia Clark's family.
And of course, there's the fact that the fire station is on the land, and it's not a 99-year lease. It's a 50-year lease that we're 20 or 30 years into.
So we're in touch with the folks at the fire station about whether anything needs to be done prior to or after merger, if merger happens. So we've wandered from calendar planning into Act 46, I believe. So I think that that's the update that we know about, you know, what's going to happen with Act 46. There's a lot that's going to happen in the next couple of weeks. There's a status meeting on the court case on Friday, so something could come out of that. There's the legislature where the Senate could take up the House passage of a bill that extended the timeline for implementation for 1 year for this district. So they kind of parsed through the districts that are part of the lawsuit, and we were in the group that they said could have another year. I haven't specifically heard why they thought that was good for us and not good for other towns, but somebody made this decision.
Six or eight of them.
Yep. I have no idea what the Senate will do with it. I don't think anyone does. I've heard different things. So we'll see how that one plays out and how soon. But it's not going to happen, you know, overnight. So we'll be waiting, I think, at least a little while.
Communicating with them, well, we'd very much like to have a year.
there's a group of people who are very active in the State House from this district. Yeah, yeah. I think they have Janet Ansel's ear, for sure. Yeah, and this
is
why. But I have heard others saying, you know, we'll give them another year, but there's no way we're undoing this. They're merging in a year. They kind of really haven't given us much other than to say, give you a little more time to get ready for the kick in the pants you're about to get.
And is the, I know you want to end this, and I'm sorry to do it. Is the discussion, the alternatives are done. It's either they accepted it or didn't, even though all the alternatives met the requirements that we didn't vote on. They've made their decision on that, but the issue about taking on others' debts,
yeah,
and taking from Calus the money they've got set aside for their capital fund, I don't want their money, that's their money. I don't think people should help us with our bond. We agreed to bond, and it's our decision. Why can't they put it as an after tax on the basic school prices? That's just not fair.
Do you want to speak to that?
Or is it a done deal, so I'll stop talking?
No, it's the law, was the answer we got.
It's their law, and it can be changed. It's a state law.
I'm with you, yeah, right.
Let's not forget that.
I'm giving you the answer that we've been given.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's not what I believe.
It's not federal law, it's a state law.
So there's no place in law, especially in Act 46, that allows for debt redistribution. That's one of the big...
And it doesn't allow for that?
It does not.
Cannot. One budget, that's it.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah, once it's consolidated, all physical property goes in the pot. And that's been an issue since 2015, that no solution has been made for. There have been suggested bills that have been shot down and refused. And people have brought up solutions.
Once this hits, I bet you there'll be a few bills. Because I don't think people understand what they've done. And it's done by 5 unappointed, unelected people. I mean, really, seriously.
I think that the real difficulty in them going back in any way at this point is that a lot of towns said, they had the incentives, they were afraid of what was going to happen to them, so they went ahead with it. So they've already done it, so they'll undo it for these towns that haven't gone along yet.
Means undoing theirs. They did this and they hated it, and they're trying to untangle everything they've done.
Yeah, we heard a lot about that, too. All right, on that happy note.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to
thank sure.
My husband's sick of hearing.
I do think if you're going to talk to David Kelly, you should. There's a lot of different elements to that lawsuit. One of them is debt. Yep. One of them is property transfer. They have 30 some towns represented, and they all have different facts on the ground.
He was on my show, but he talked in general because he just was filing the lawsuit, so he couldn't get into it. But he said he'd come back and talk about the details, so I can get that out to people.
So that leaves us in a place where we're preparing for both situations, hopefully. Maybe merger's not happening, maybe merger's happening in a year, maybe merger is happening very, very soon. So we're trying to plan for all those scenarios. And it leaves, I just want to acknowledge again that it leaves the administration, the teachers, it leaves everybody in a bad place with this hanging over, this uncertainty hanging over them. And we certainly can appreciate that and would love to have we're proud that they can continue to focus on education while we're all wrangling with this stuff.
What it's all about.
Anything else under the discussion agenda? So under 4.0, we have reports to the board. Sure. Yeah.
Have you guys heard from anybody else that's interested in becoming a board member? I'm just wondering because the only other thing other than at this point the select board meeting to appoint somebody after town meeting is if somebody does a write-in thing, and so I was just wondering if there's anybody you've heard of.
Not for the local board. I know of a couple of people who I won't name who may be interested in the merged board when that comes around. Yep. And that's going to come around soon. We heard that's one thing we did hear from Bill tonight that you may already be familiar with. clerk's office, but that if this organizational meeting chooses, was it April 2nd as the date for our annual meeting, that the petitions to be on the full board, the merged board, would be due on February 25th.
That's earlier on the board.
Yeah.
So you need to know about that.
So I need to get that word out.
And he said he has a format for that petition.
Yeah, yeah, the Secretary of State's office, the town clerk's office has those petitions.
So in other words, on the 19th, that would be figured out as far as when.
And to pick the annual meeting.
If it would be an April 2nd, then say that it's gonna be on the 5th, that you said petition.
Petitions would be due, yeah. And I will make sure that's communicated to the two people I know are interested.
And I would have to do another petition?
No, so you're running for the local board.
Okay.
You've already gotten your petition in, you are on the ballot, if I understand correctly.
Okay.
And so you and Vera will be on the ballot for the five positions. So after town meeting day, we will not have a quorum of this board, and the select board will need to appoint one member.
Unless there's a write-in.
Unless there's a write-in candidate, 20 signatures, something like that.
We would need 20 signatures on the same position.
All in the same position, oh.
Correct.
So they have to.
That's why I was wondering if there's anybody interested to try to help point that out. But so, right, exactly. But so either Vera or Nicole, they could also be interested in the other.
Sure.
Board too.
Yeah.
So then either or both of them would fall into needing to do something by the 25th.
That's what I was asking.
Okay, that's what you're asking, got it. So yes, if you were interested in that.
Okay.
You wanna do, go visit your people again and get 20 more signatures.
I just did it.
Could you sign this again?
Vacancies, the other remaining people have the requisite knowledge and history here to get through.
Yeah, right.
Vera does, doesn't she?
She does, Vera's definitely does.
Hi, nice to meet you, Nicole.
Nicole's new to the board, but she's jumped right in.
Because you need people that have the history to know.
Vera's got more history than any of us, I think, well, maybe Peter's got more history. His history goes farther back.
Ancient history.
Ancient history.
All histories. It's not the way it used to be, Peter, that's all I have to say.
Yeah, it's true.
Can I ask who do they appoint for the three vacancies if there are three?
Anybody who's interested, yeah.
Anybody, like, how do they determine, like, where does that?
It would just like you.
You're breathing and you raise your hand, I bet you get a list.
Oh my God.
If you make a phone call and somebody's gonna tell you you need to actually write up something to submit it, and so it depends if they get multiple people that are interested, but the select board would only be responsible to get this board back to form. And this board, once it's at form, could appoint the other people.
And I've gotta make sure that I reach out to the select board and warn them that this is coming if they don't know already, get it on their next meeting.
Therefore, they're planning on keeping their March 7th meeting, now that they've gone from Monday to Thursday meetings.
Yep.
They realize that they should keep that Thursday meeting, but they won't necessarily have anybody that they could appoint at that point.
So I sent Krista an SOS.
Krista is
assistant to Bill Campbell, and she can update you better on what's planned for meetings next week.
Oh, okay, good.
Oh, because that was
Thanks, Krista.
I'm a little confused because you said the announcements app. I'm going. The website. Okay,
yeah.
Sorry.
I just haven't updated it. It's an additional my other work website. So, Tuesday, board meeting, 6 o'clock here at the auditorium. There will be signage all over the place. We'll have ropes so it's easy for people to navigate. We've been working with the town clerks on the setup for that. With my understanding that the transitional board was actually going to have a meeting right after that.
That's what Bill said, yeah.
Okay. Just for organizational purposes.
Okay.
Chair, vice chair, stuff like that. So I wasn't sure about one on Wednesday.
Maybe or maybe not.
I heard him say also.
It sounded like he thought there would still be one on Wednesday.
It is in your what?
SU board meeting?
Yes.
No, in here. He said that.
Sorry.
Okay.
A lot of it's up in the air.
I think the organizational meeting could be a very long meeting, so it might be a very quick transitional board meeting after would be my guess, and then maybe more business the next night.
But so then he also said articles meeting on Thursday.
Yes.
But again, we won't clear what time.
They're usually 5:30 to 7:30, and it will be in room 128, 131 here at U32.
That's where the U32 board.
Yep.
Thank you, Krista.
Yeah, as soon as they firm up, then I'll send out the calendar notices.
Okay.
And I send the agenda as soon as I'm.
Thank you, Krista.
Thank you.
All right. Let's see. SOS to Krista.
Yes, that's what text messaging works. I tried Bill, but his phone doesn't work for text.
So reports to the board, 4.1 administration, anything?
Yeah, I can talk about a few things.
Sure.
So I think typically there's a report in your packet, but I'm not seeing one this time around, so I can give an overview of what I had. Was going to be in there.
Oh, there was one in the carousel packet.
This is a good thing.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it's on page 40.
Not the carousel, the big, the bigger meeting.
Yeah, sorry if it's your first time around. Can you try to give it a little
more? I saw it somewhere.
Okay.
Page 40.
Mm-hmm. Yep, page 40.
So as usual, I'd like to talk a little bit about some of the happenings at Berlin Elementary, some of the things that kids are doing, some things that teachers are doing. And I appreciate comment that was made just that, amidst all of the things that you guys are working on, we're still doing what we do. Even though I know Bill's done a great job at getting information out to teachers and staff that seek it, there aren't a lot of questions. There's not a lot of angst or worry that I'm feeling. I think things are going well within the building. Trust that the process will happen as it happens, and we'll work through it as we have to as teachers and as staff. So it hasn't affected any quality of work, I guess, is what I'm trying to say at this point. So it's good. A couple things that are upcoming, and some things that we've been working on. This time of year, a lot of schools do something called Winter Wellness, and for Berlin Elementary, we have an annual Winter Wellness Day. Students do unique outdoor activities, typically involving snow.
Got plenty of
and if not, then we either don't have it or we do some other things. But we have that coming up next week, and give you kind of a sense of what it is. Students are grouped in not just age or grade level groups, but groups that span K to 6, so they get a chance to work with older and younger students together in a team building kind of way. We have unique things from shelter building, wilderness survival kind of thing when it comes to being outside in the winter, room ball. So even though we are going to be going on ice and playing hockey, kind of give a little bit of a sense of playing hockey through a game of room ball. We're doing something called instead of the Iditarod, the Berlinerod challenge, and we'll have a contest instead of sleds like dog sleds, we'll have regular sleds and a competition through a course. So that'll be fun. We do have cross country skis at Berlin, and even though students do have a chance to use them, it doesn't happen often where all students have a chance. So we're going to be doing cross country skiing, snowshoeing through our nature trail. Looks to be a fun event, and that's coming up. One of the new things that we are doing is something that I think was attempted in years past, but on our school lunch menu, we are trying to better label where our school where the food comes from. We have a farm to school committee. Obviously, we have a wonderful school garden. And Dave Moyer, our new head chef, has really taken on trying to just bring a little more education to the kids when it comes to our garden food, where our food is purchased from, where it comes from. So we have a new labeling system on our menu that I believe is reflected in February's menu, where the one asterisk next to a particular item means that food comes from Berlin specifically. Two asterisks is it comes from Washington County, three it comes from the state of Vermont, four is in New England or New York regional product. And we also realize that we do get some products out of Canada, some of our root vegetables come out of Canada. So that's a 5-star indication on that. So it's neat for parents to see, it's neat for kids to see, and that's something new that is happening. Yes, thank you. Yes, so we had a food service audit last week, and folks come in and go through, you know, like any audit, a number of different things to see if we're doing everything properly per statute and per regulation. And we got an excellent review from the gentleman that came in.
Yep.
Some of the more important highlights is financially, we're doing well with buying and revenue when it comes to the program. So things are going well there. We're a model for our fruit vegetable program, which is our daily snack of the day, we call it. And so Dave also, through a grant, acquires a unique fruit or vegetable that kids try. See if it's something that they might like. You name it, we've had it, we've tried it. So that's going really well. That's,
and the other big highlight was I love the announcements that you guys announced, the menu for the day. So you guys have one of the best promotional for your food program that they've seen. So it was just an outstanding one.
Yeah.
I'm so happy.
I love the feedback. Yeah. Nice. So thank you for reminding me about that.
Well, when you said food, that was right here.
So two other quick things. I know I've talked about our whole school monthly meetings. During those meetings, we celebrate accomplishments, we review certain things that might be coming up or that have been initiatives, we reinforce positive choices and behaviors that have happened throughout the month, and each class gets to present something. And this past month for February, our third and fourth grade class, Mrs. Mitchell, did a beautiful Black History Month collage where each student had a piece of this collage, and each piece had different words that talked about bringing people together in a peaceful way. So each month the teacher presents something with the class. Actually, the kids are the ones that present it, and it's a really great way for them to stand in front of their peers share their celebration, share their work. But I've even had students that have asked to perform. So I've had students that so far have sang a song in front of the school, played some instruments in front of the school. I have a brother and sister duo that want to do a puppet show. So I'm open to those kinds of things. And I think what's really great is that it gives kids a chance to stand up in front of an audience and speak. Kids have, and adults have a fear of. So I always have an eye on students that might want to be able to do that and embrace that. It's an important skill to have for our future generations to stand in front of people and speak. So the last thing I just wanted to share is at staff meetings, we have done a better job at looking at student data. Last month, and even just today at our staff meeting, groups of teachers get together, look at student assessment data, and then they have to provide me an action plan of what they're going to do with what they see in the data. So if they see certain groups of students struggling, or particular topic went very well and students got it, or even students that might need to, that might be exceeding and need an extra challenge, they get a chance to sit down and look through that work. But it not only gives them a chance to look at where some of the needs might be, but an expectation for me that they show me what they're going to do about it. And it's gone really well. Teachers have worked really collaboratively together to really think about instructional practices through this process. So that's a good thing, in my opinion. And that's all I have in my report. Do we have any overall questions about anything that's going on or wonderings?
Any questions for Aaron? I'll just say that I attended a really nice winter concert and art show. And something you said at the beginning of that, I'm going to put you on the spot a little bit. You said that this was the best school you'd ever worked in, and I was wondering what made you say that.
I've heard other people say this, so this is my feelings, but also confirmed with other folks. The school has a real positive feeling. I know that kind of sounds cliche, but the intricacies of people working together that make it positive is what really stands out. I don't know if that makes sense, but the attitudes of the adults and how that is presented, I think has a positive impact on kids and anybody that walks in the building. So it's that feeling. It's a cultural climate kind of thing. And it's seen when and heard when teachers are talking to each other that they have the best interest of the student. It's not about their needs, it's not about something else, it's about the kids. And that's a theme that is happening just all the time. To have teachers in the profession that truly have that that belief that they're not there for them, they're there for the kids, and will do anything to help them is what I see as such a huge positive thing. So that's kind of the crux of that. So thanks for putting me on the spot.
You're welcome. thanks for sharing that. It's really good to hear.
Sure.
Back to what you were saying about the menu. I was wondering if to go along with the asterisks, if there's any thought about having some type of narrative to tell a little bit more about the Berlin and local sources. And I'm also wondering if there's any talk about attempts to increase those, or if you guys are feeling that you're at a good place with those. It's a discussion that's happened in the past, and also I just don't know where it is.
Increase more local?
Yeah. But maybe it has been.
Oh, that's definitely the goal, is to try to get as much Berlin local and state as possible. I think it comes down to what's available, where, and the cost of it. So there is a balance. I think they've done a good job through our audit to show that if there's something local, if there's something town, and it helps maintain the budget piece of it, then we're all for it. There's certain things that come from certain places, and that's how it is,
Well, I'm just thinking, in sharing out with the rest of the community, I'm sure they'd be interested where in the community or in the county it's coming from.
Gotcha.
And there might be sources that you guys aren't aware of. There's a lot of local agricultural stuff that doesn't necessarily get promoted in our town.
Interesting.
So, I think the asterisks are great as far as drawing is, but
yeah, it's weird. Even
newsletter? Yeah, we've done some of that in school, like it might say it's like something like the farm, but only the kids see that, and that's part of the in-house stuff that we do, but to make it more public is, I think, what you're saying, so yeah.
Are the kids ever able to integrate that with cooking? Taste the food, like cooking the food? I don't know.
Well, we've done a lot of that mostly with our own garden crop that we get in the fall,
right.
So our we learn so much that comes out of that, and try to get some to the kitchen. So for that, that back to school night, and so that's kind of how we get that.
All right, thank you, Aaron. We don't have anything on our action agenda. We do have approved board orders under 6.0, and I just want to make sure, Nicole, so these are, I don't know if you've done this before, but these are the board, so these are all the expenses that we need to authorize. They send them out in advance so that we can take a look at them. And then once everybody has signed off on them, we need a motion to approve the board order and the amount that's on the front page.
You want that as two separate motions?
Are there two?
Black pen, okay.
There's a grand total, yeah.
Can be the grand total.
There's a grand total, I think, on the front sheet.
I would make a motion.
Do I have this back?
Sure.
To approve the board order. I don't have a date or anything like this. Well, I do. 12/31 through January 3rd and January 8th through February 11th. For a total of $234,887.62. The amount? $234,887.62.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Any discussion? Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. The ayes have it. And the board.
Do you have any other questions on the financial
Did we skip?
Oh, we did. Oh,
I'm
so sorry, Lori. Yep,
but.
Let's go back to 4.2 finance, and if there's anything you want to point out to us there.
I can just do a quick buzz through, if that's okay.
Please. I'm
so
sorry about that.
So the items that are dated in the middle that are updated in January, those are the ones I was discussing at the other meeting. For your particular school, I'm on page 13. There's miscellaneous income that says prior year savings, and what that was, we thought we might need another quarter of oil at the end of the year, and we did not. So we saved $9,679 there. Do you see where I am?
Yes.
Okay. For special ed, when you spend less, you receive less. So you will be receiving less special ed reimbursement because the projected benefits were cheaper. People change their health collections. So we get back 56% roughly. And so the special ed reimbursements are down because in total the special ed spending is down. The other revenue change was interest income went up. That is a projected 20,000. So all total three revenue changes increased the fund balance by $19,938. Under spending, the preschool, basically we have a shared supervisory union service for the students who are not attending your school. They're attending other daycares, and the state gives Berlin money to pay those daycares. It's called Act 166. So you're actually saving $1,300 for that budget line this year. I talked about the salary and benefit update primarily with sped savings. You're forecasted to save about $5,500, and that's primarily electricity because of all the construction improvements. You are saving money on electricity, so that's $5,510. And you voted to transfer $108,000 to the capital fund, so that is so noted. $50,000 in it, and then you voted to move the extra $108,000. So the total
served her.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I have a quick question.
Sure.
Budget transfer, additional 108.
Right.
You said 158, should that be 133?
The budget originally had a $50,000 transfer in it, and when I added the 108, it became 158.
One of the savings we decided in our special meetings, the last couple of meetings, was to decrease that $50,000 to $25,000.
Well, that's in next year's budget.
Okay, all right.
This is this year.
Okay.
Yeah, we're having two different years, yeah.
Good.
Hey, I have to do this all the time, I got. Okay, so I'm back on the kitchen. So if you go onto page 15, if you kind of look over at the bottom right, you'll see that your food staff has gone from 72 meals average per day to 76, which is an increase, which is great. And you'll see we have participation primarily in lunch, but a little bit more breakfast. So that's kind of the highlights. You can see I just love talking about lunch.
It was never a firm quote. That number kept shifting on us, if I remember right.
I think there was a rough estimate for three types of treatment. Peanut black, the full paving, and then the total reclamation and subsurface and full paving. I can't remember. That's a rough estimate from a memory.
Yeah, that's good. That sounded familiar.
And then we heard afterward that it would be the full reclamation was actually going to be more expensive than that, but I don't know that we got a firm quote.
So there's no plans, or are there plans?
The only plan is, I think, is setting aside money in the capital fund, knowing that we have to do it.
I would love it.
So I think we just found a future agenda item.
Yeah. I would love to talk about that.
From a historical perspective, when I was on the board before, we were talking about painting the parking lot.
Wow.
The front was fine.
Yeah. Right.
It's been a while.
Right. And I think there might be some
lost in space now.
Wetland issues with paving the parking lot. That's what I've heard.
Well, there would be drainage or runoff. Yeah.
Right. You have to have, what do you call it, a pond or whatever?
Yeah, something pond.
Right around in elementary school.
Right? Probably would never have water in the soils that we have.
Okay.
That's
so we'll put paving on there. And before we get off this, any other questions for Lori about the financial report? Right. Thank you, Lori. We have paving. Any other future agenda items? Of course, we'll be talking about Act 46. Of course, we'll be talking about town meeting day, I'm sure, at post-town meeting. Anything else you'd like to see on that?
Are there any school issues that have been put aside since all we've been talking about is that?
I guess I'm just a love more shared celebrations from you. And I appreciate your comments to the annual report. And I think since 2015, prior to 2015, being on the board was so much about making the school better and helping fix the problems in any way we could. We've been so distracted by Act 46, it's nice to have you share with us some stuff about the education and the school environment, the school climate, things that were of utmost importance as a board member prior to 2015. So I appreciate that. I'd love to hear more of that next meeting.
There have been some good presentations despite Act 46. I don't know if this kind of will ground to certain types of those again.
Types of?
Of presentations. Like, I think you came last year when there was one on Genius Hour.
Yep.
And there have been a couple others. I can't think what hasn't been touched on in quite some time.
Yeah.
But
so maybe we could brainstorm that a little bit for something to possibly come before the board.
I had also was wondering about the discipline, not just the discipline program, but what was the other program Kelly was talking about?
SEL.
Yeah, and how is that working at our school? And what, like, I don't know, what do we have teachers participating in that? Or I just.
Yep.
So maybe we can talk about that.
Yeah, I don't know if you want me to. I can talk briefly about a couple of things, just help answer your question.
Yeah, or is it enough to put on a future agenda item? I mean, you want to do that?
Yeah,
let's do that. Let's set it on the next agenda.
Nice to hear the positive stuff.
Yeah. I could try and name my report, get to some other happenings and some of the positives for sure. So I'll continue to do that.
Okay.
One other town meeting question. I don't know whether it was this board or the town offices that had ORCA reported last year, so I don't know who, if there's been any discussion of if people thought that was a worthwhile thing and if anybody's going to ask that happen again. I have no idea who chose to do it last year.
To record town meeting.
I noticed it when I was going through photos of the town report. That
it wasn't us.
Showed
us.
It wasn't, was it?
No. It may have just been ORCA taking it upon themselves.
I don't think they do that. So I guess I could ask Dana tomorrow if it was either.
Yeah. Any other board communication? Any other business? Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved. Second.
And there we go. At 8:30. Look at that. 90 minutes exactly. No. Thank you, everybody.